Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I will be talking about why Nico Rosberg was such an underrated driver. But I'm doing this with a special guest. I'm doing this video with South Bear, and if you haven't subscribed yet to his channel, please do that. Just click the icon button on the top right and subscribe to his channel. But now let's start with the video and talk about why Nico Rosberg was such an underrated driver. Nico Rosberg started his Formula 1 career with Williams in 2007, and his teammate Mark Webber was alongside him. But after just one season, after the 2011 season, Mark Webber left for, obviously, Red Bull Racing, as we all know. But that means Nico Rosberg had to lead the Williams team in just his second year in Formula 1, and we know how difficult it is to lead a Formula 1 team. But he had to do that straight away in his second year. He had to lead the Williams team in 2008. But he has done that perfectly. In the first race in 2008, he stood on the podium in Melbourne with his fellow friend Lewis Hamilton. They were childhood friends, spent their childhood together. There's actually a great scene where they are hugging each other out before the podium celebration in Melbourne. He was, throughout the 2008 season, he was really, really consistent too. And then in 2009, he was still with Williams F1, and he ended up being best of the rest in Formula 1 in that season, and he had a great season, obviously without any podiums, without any huge performances that people would notice, but very, very consistent, finished P7, somewhat like Carlos Sainz did in 2019 or Sergio Perez in 2014. So a great season in 2009, very consistent from Nico Rosberg. But now we move to 2010, where he made the big move to Mercedes to partner Michael Schumacher, who came out of his retirement after he retired at the end of 2006. Michael Schumacher came back to Formula One to Mercedes. Obviously, Mercedes at that time was a new project. Mercedes bought the team that was known as Braun GP in 2009, that actually won the championship in 2009 with Jenson Button. But yeah. Nico Rosberg moved to Mercedes in that year, and that obviously was a huge move for him and partnering Michael Schumacher. And in 2010, he had a great season. He scored in 15 out of 19 races, the same amount of races as Sebastian Vettel scored in that year. And Sebastian Vettel, as we all know, was world champion in 2010, his maiden world championship. But that was not the only great thing in his first year in Mercedes, or in this time with Mercedes. He was obviously partnered with Michael Schumacher from 2010 to the end of 2012. And over the whole three seasons, Nico Rosberg outscored Michael Schumacher. Yes, obviously we didn't see the prime Michael Schumacher, the prime Ferrari Michael Schumacher in Formula One at that time. Many people say it was the biggest mistake Michael Schumacher could have made to come back to Formula One in 2010. But still, it is a great achievement from Nico Rosberg to outscore Michael Schumacher in all three seasons. That was a great job from Nico Rosberg.
And now over to you, South Bear.
Thanks for having me, Jojo. First of all, Nico pushed the team forward and helped the team a lot with development over the years, as the Mercedes team went from P4 to P2 in the constructor standings from 2010 to 2013. Nico also struggled at the start of 2012, but after a smart invention called Double DRS, Nico won the Chinese Grand Prix, a win no one expected. Rosberg was always a consistent driver, finishing almost always in the points in his Mercedes time, and when the car was able to finish on the podium, Nico did that, and that's a sign of a great consistent driver. At the start of 2013, a certain Lewis Hamilton joined the team, and these two knew each other from karting when they were teammates. Lewis beat Nico in 2013, as Nico had one win and one more DNF than Lewis, and one of those wins was at Monaco, his first win in the Principality, a race which he went on to win a further two times in 2014 and 2015. After Lewis beat Nico in 2013, he got in the head of the German, and Lewis won the championship, as this psychological edge forced Nico into errors. Nico always pushed Lewis, as he was in P2 when Lewis was in P1 most of the times, and that's another sign of a very consistent driver. This championship came down to the final race, but after an engine issue, the chances were not there anymore for Nico, and so it was Lewis who won it. In the 2014 season, there also were incidents between the two drivers in Monaco, when Nico broke too late, forcing a yellow flag in the final Q3 run for the two, and in Belgium, where Lewis retired and Nico finished second after a first lap incident.
Thank you very, very much, South Bear, for your contribution. But now we move to 2016 and the season, in my opinion, which makes Nico Rosberg. In 2016, Nico Rosberg obviously won the world championship and got the world championship away from its arch rival, Lewis Hamilton. That obviously was a huge achievement in itself. But personally, I think there's more to it in that 2016 season. I think the way that Nico Rosberg fought back in that season and how he stayed strong mentally was also a huge achievement after 2 years of 3 years actually of huge battling with Lewis Hamilton in 2014, in 2015, after the setback in 2015 that he had. Obviously, Lewis Hamilton dominated Nico Rosberg in 2015. I just think how Nico Rosberg responded in 2016 and came back and showed Lewis Hamilton, who he's actually racing against, is just phenomenal, I think, in my opinion. And not many drivers are able to do that. And yes, I know, many people say, yes, Nico Rosberg only won the 2016 championship because of Lewis DNF in Malaysia. But actually, if you look at the bigger picture, both had reliability issues from 2014 to 2016. The most noticeable one, and the one that you can see on screen currently, when Nico Rosberg couldn't start in Singapore in 2014. That's just one example. But over the whole three seasons from 2014 to 2016, Lewis Hamilton actually only had four reliability issues, and Nico Rosberg had a whole five reliability issues. So people saying, yes, Nico Rosberg only won the championship because of Lewis DNF in Malaysia 2016 is totally false. So now we come to the final point why we think Nico Rosberg is such an underrated driver. Lewis Hamilton is obviously considered as the GOAT, the greatest of all time, because, you know, he's won seven world championship titles, the same as Michael Schumacher, and is, with Michael Schumacher, the most successful. But Nico Rosberg didn't only manage to beat Lewis Hamilton over one season. He was always pressurizing Lewis Hamilton and keeping Lewis Hamilton on his toes, unlike Valtteri Bottas. Yes, Valtteri Bottas won a few races in the Mercedes, but it was just not the same as how Nico Rosberg used to be. Valtteri Bottas can't just put up a fight every race weekend with Lewis Hamilton. Sometimes also because there's too much respect between Valtteri Bottas and Lewis Hamilton. Unlike with Nico Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton, when Nico Rosberg was always pressurizing Lewis Hamilton and pushing him, and there was no clear number one or number two and at Mercedes, and coming into the race weekend, both of them would have had the chance to win. Unlike nowadays with Valtteri Bottas, where Valtteri Bottas can put up a fight at every race weekend, unlike Nico Rosberg did over his season with Lewis Hamilton. Plus, I think Nico Rosberg made Lewis Hamilton a better driver and ultimately made Lewis Hamilton the driver he is today. After Lewis lost to Nico Rosberg in 2016, Lewis came back a different driver in 2017, and since then, he really got to another level and stepped up. And that's obviously because I think that's also because of the fact that he lost to his arch rival Nico Rosberg in 2016. So all in all, these were the facts and the things why we think that Nico Rosberg is such an underrated driver. Obviously, he had a huge Formula One career, as we just saw, as you might have just noticed. So yeah, definitely a huge underrated driver. But at this moment, I would like to thank South Bear for participating in this video and doing this video with myself. A huge thanks to him, and please subscribe to his channel if you want to see more great Formula One content. So yeah, thank you very, very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I really, really hope so you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.